It's your boy Jason, the barber and educator. We're going to do here today, we're going to demonstrate a flat top here. And these are the instruments you'll need. You need a flat top comb, dark comb, light hair. Light hair, dark comb. We got a fade comb and the brush. We got some styling gel for a hold the flat top in place. He wants a high and tight flat top, all right? So what we're gonna do here, you need any ball you tool you use to ball out the sizing. Whichever you like to ball out with best. Me personally today, I'm gonna start with my 5-0 on my ceramic advanced clipper. I'm gonna go in, start right here, below behind the ear so I can make sure his ears are cleaned up good. That's the part people forget a lot, to clean up the grip behind the ear. So one good rule of thumb is to just start there and you ain't gotta worry about the deep. You can go up high because he wants a high and tight. Some people would like to start with the flat top first. You know, either way is fine. I just like to go ahead and frame everything out first. Now that I got the sides cut off, I'm gonna finish my line with the top for the high. It's high, but it ain't tight yet. It's high. A lot of people got busy sets on high and tight. It be high, but it don't be tight. They just need that line. That means it's high, but it ain't tight. All right. Next, I'm gonna go and get it a little extra clean to make it shape down here. Of course, you come back at the end before you let them go and clean up. You know, they're gonna clean up about the back of them. Now, if I don't get this flat top right, y'all won't see this video.
I'll be back in 2 weeks. Video again.
All right. Got it nice and smooth here. Several things we can do. We can take our adjustable clipper and fade. We can take the tassel blade clipper, the OA blade, like I guess I do now. And we're gonna break it down some more here. To lighten it up, to set you up for your, to blend it out. We have that. We're gonna leave the sides here. Okay. Can I adjust the clipper and work on this line here? Going on your toes, come out on your heel. Get a little bending going there. Let's straighten all your lines out. Okay, open it up. Got a little more to work with in there. Once you're familiar with fading techniques, just do whatever you need to do to get it faded out. Now what we can do is get our trimmers. We're gonna get our trimmer and we wanna establish our line here. Right on the side. Same thing on the other side. And of course, you're not gonna see other stuff. Way, you know, where you can clean up the fade a little more, just like any other fade. You can always go back in and clean it up. Now, let's focus on the top, the main part of the tutorial. I want to go in first. Here's a high loaded one on the top. You want it pretty flat on top?
Leave it a bit.
Okay.
Half an inch to three quarters. Right. Not super short.
He don't want his real short down to the skull. Okay, some people have it even, so even bald right here at the apex, in the center. So normally I would go like a 1.5 here. We're going to start him like a 2. I'm going to take my number 2 blade. On my ceramic advanced clipper. Any detachable blade clipper will work. And first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go where beginning this apex, right where it begins to slow down. And I'm gonna start here, and I'm gonna go all the way back to the end of the apex where it starts to slow down, here. And I'm gonna establish, that's a guideline I'm gonna establish for the flat top. I'm going straight in here. And I'm just going to rock it. I'm just going to rock it right here. Get nice, clean. So this is your guideline for the whole haircut at the top. You got to get that nice and clean. You need all the hairs there flat as possible. Okay. Once you establish that guideline, you're going to get a close-up look. Okay. Now you ask your customer, do they want the hair here in the back, or do they want the horseshoe look where this is sloped and cleaned off here? Do you want this back here?
Clean.
Clean? Okay. Here's customer preference. is to have this part taken off. So when you do your, so when you establish the guideline at the top of the apex, when they have a preference to have this cleaned off, and which creates what's called a horseshoe, you would take it, and instead of stopping here, where it starts to slope down, you'll go ahead and take it on down. Hence, you have to come back and do a little more fading in here to take that line. So now you would take the guideline all the way down here. So it's here, it stops here normally because some people want to see that box look in the back. But he wants that horseshoe and wants it to follow the contour of his scalp. So we're going to come out here. Okay. Do you come back, go against the line here, because you're going to fade this line out. Then you're going to come over here, around a parietal ridge. You're going to go and fade out my parietal ridge since he don't want this part here. You're going to need the horseshoe here. Take any clipper, whatever you normally need to do to blend. Start it back. I got it.
It's ready.
So what we're doing here, we're just blending and fading in. Okay. Now, if you look good at our model's hair, you'll see how he got this hair laying over right here. Shit laying down. And also on this side. It's laying down. It's starting to take a different direction. This hair going that way, this way. So that's where the challenge comes in. He wants this hair sticking up and flat on the top, level with this guideline that you created here. So what we're gonna do here. Actually get a little more fade down here. Can't get this hair to stand up soft. You're gonna try to cut it even, and it's gonna keep moving on you and all that, so you have to put product in the hair. This is where the gel comes in. Now get this hair to stand up here. Stiff as possible. Okay, A lot of people like to use those flat top of cones and all that. It don't work for me, it creates more work for me. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go back to the 5-aught blade. Something I know cuts flat and smooth. I like how smooth the blade is here. It allows me to be smooth against the flat top cone. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna try to level this as possible. There's gonna be, this horseshoe here is gonna be slightly higher than the flat, just slightly higher than the guideline, because he don't want his hair too short. Okay, as you can see the horseshoe shape. All right, here we go. So don't forget, this is my guideline, man. I'm gonna come here. I'm not gonna tilt the comb here. I'm just gonna try to go straight across. Sometimes you have to come from that angle and also from this angle. Same guideline, I can come here. Guideline here. It's not down here like this, it's not resting on the wood slope. It's resting here, level with the guideline. You gotta get the hair to come through the comb to you. We will slope slightly here because of heat, the type of flat top you wanted. It's the one that goes down in the back. So on these edges here, you will slope some. But when you get back up here, you're gonna stay level with the guideline. Time you have to get down to eye level so you can see what's going on with the haircut. Even though you got a guideline you created, you're resting the comb on the fast hand, but when you go out to the edge, sometimes you got to freehand it. Take a look at your work. Let me get them head on. Take a look. Now I can see here where my one big mistake we make with flat top is if this hump is higher than the sides. So we gotta look for that. You gotta make sure you don't have that. If you do have that, what you do is just go back in a little bit. You just get a guard that maybe that's a little bit smaller than what you used to establish your original guideline. And you would just kind of come in and kind of just right on the tippy-tippy-tip. That's the only part you have. There we go. Now, it's not over yet. That's your first run. You want to clean your flat top off. You want to do it again. You know, some people feel like you should do it at least 3 times. It just depends on what it looked like to me. But, okay. do something different this time. I'm gonna get a lighter gel. A lighter hold. That was mega, her firm hold. I'm gonna do a regular. Sometimes it's preference, depending on the client. You see it all coming together. So, and you can just, like I said, get eye level. And you can see if you need to do any tweaking. Good to me. And if you got one or two hairs standing up on the side, feel free to freehand it here. But don't ever try to freehand the whole flat top. It's not going to work. You be my guest, though. And there we have it. Nice clean flat top. High and tight. Let the client see. Okay.
Well done. Thank you.
Alright. Jason. Barber and Educator.